A groundbreaking study is underway to assess and quantify the health and production benefits to feedlot cattle using cattle handling methods known as acclimation. Acclimation is a process of controlled human interaction with cattle that builds on the principles of low-stress cattle handling. Besides benefits to the cattle, the study is also examining the benefits to feedlot staff of having acclimation skills. The Benefits of Acclimation study is being funded by Meat and Livestock Australia using grain-fed cattle levies and is being led by feedlot veterinary consultant Dr. Tony Batterham from Corinda, New South Wales.
The key objectives of the Benefits of Acclimation study was to answer an industry question, which was, if we use stockmanship principles known as acclimation and use those handling methods, do we actually confer a benefit to the cattle? And is that benefit in health? Is it in production? Are we advancing animal welfare? Or do any of all the combination of the three occur by utilising these methods in the feedlot environment?
The study has run for 18 months so far and involves five trial sites, two in New South Wales at JBS Australia's Caruna feedlot and Elders Kalara feedlot, and three in Queensland at Teeth Australia's Condamine feedlot, Smithfield Cattle Company's Proston feedlot and Morton Co's Grassdale feedlot.
At Grassdale here, we've currently got 41,000 head of cattle on feed. And we're just in the process of doing an expansion, and that'll get us up to about 54,000 cattle. Grassdale, Morton Co have become part of the study because we want to know more about what the benefits of acclimation are in the feedlot process. Such a big opportunity for driving profitability and animal welfare benefits for not only us, but for the balance of the industry as well too.
The study involves feedlot staff working with cattle both on foot and on horse, using set protocols across all of the trial sites. Before starting the study, all staff involved in the trial received training from livestock handling consultant Boyd Holden to become a certified acclimator.
To start with, the cattle are chute scored, their temperament scored through the induction shed. This is where we build the treatment and the control lot. To remove bias from the experiment, we actually separate the sources of origin into treatment and control pens, and we build those lots. It's a range of behavioural measurements that we measure there, but we've also set up cameras in order to measure flight speed out of the chute, and we build a score then around temperament of the cattle before they even start the acclimation process. Once they're in the pens, we've got all sorts of measures around health and production, such as in the health area, we look at how much morbidity is the pen, how many animals do we need to remove from the pen and treat. Also in the production, we look at things like average daily gain and their conversion. We also have a look at while they're in the pen, we've got a 24/7 camera rolling on the treatment and the control pens. We're able to actually overlay some software into that footage to see that when the acclimators come in or there's any other stimuli in the pen, such as when a feed truck arrives or when there's staff are cleaning the water troughs, any of those sort of stimuli, what the cattle actually behave like before and after that event. We can review that footage. The other thing that we can do is put some software over the top of the footage and measure things like flight zone, flight speed, some of those kind of objective parameters as well to see if there's a difference between the treatment and the control pen.
Fecal cortisol levels are also being measured to monitor stress levels in the cattle.
In addition to all those on-feedlot measurements, we're also adding the carcass data to this experiment and measuring if there's a difference between the treatment and control pen in terms of how they actually grade in the abattoir. Carcass weights, MSA grading, all of that is combined with the feedlot data and the initial chute scoring data to build an analysis as to whether there's a difference between the treatment cattle and the control cattle.
Three groups are involved in the project: Corindai Veterinary Group, Bovine Dynamics and Management for Technology. A final report on the study's findings is expected in mid-2017.